Hey guys, I wanted to make a quick video going over some of the Steam Deck joystick grips that I've accumulated over the past 6 months that I've owned it. And I'm going to be looking at the level of grip, the comfort of the caps, and how well the capacitive sensor works with them on, as well as the looks in some cases. So to get started, I've got my deck here just without anything on it, and we're in Halo Infinite with my gyro controls turned on with the right stick. So the default, I guess, behavior, not default, but how I've got it set up. And we can see the way the sensor works. You kind of need your thumb to be really directly on that sensor for it to pick up. You can't really do stuff like this. You see, I'm not, it'll cut in and out with the default, if your thumb isn't fully on it. So, with that out of the way, let's get started with our first set. This first set I see a lot, and I'm going to put the links to all of these in the description so that you can see what it is I'm referring to. But I see these a lot. These are probably my least favorite. So, first thing is, they go on. I was gonna say they go on easy, because they're really big. They don't fit the deck all that well. So you have some gyro control, but again, it's pretty inconsistent. It's not what I would see. Even now, why is it not going? My full entire thumb is on it, and I'm pushing into the stick. And it doesn't want to go. So sometimes it will work and sometimes it doesn't. So pretty inconsistent. Not a fan of the big protruding dots. You can really feel them, and all it takes is 5 seconds for me to want to stop using them. They're just a little too aggro. Pretty grippy. I mean, they're not slippery, that's for sure. They're just not comfortable for long use. And like I said, gyro is not working. So that's pretty much a non-starter for these. Not a big fan. They come in a pack of like 40 with all kinds of different colors, but it doesn't really matter. These two are kind of interesting. They came along with a case on Amazon that I found, and I didn't really care about the case, but because these were interesting new joystick covers, I thought I'd see if they were any good. And the answer is they are not. These big grills are pretty, not. You can feel them when you're playing. So let's put them on. These are also pretty big, pretty loose, and don't really fit the Steam Deck all that well. And as you can see, we got a little bit of gyro going on. It's cutting in and out. These definitely don't feel as bad as the last ones, for sure. But you can still feel these grates. Excuse me. And it didn't feel great after about 30 minutes of playing. So I am also not a fan of these. I do have a favorite that I will be recommending at the end of the video. I just wanted to go over basically all of the ones I've tried. This is another one that comes with it that's taller. And obviously, when you go taller, you can expect to not get your gyro working. Some people don't care about that. They might just care about comfort, or they just need something that's grippier, and I can understand that. So in terms of grippiness, again, this is pretty good grip compared to the default Steam Deck, which is kind of slippery. It's just not the most comfortable option out there, and I don't know why you would get these. They're just kind of like a cheap add-on to a case, and the case wasn't that good. Just a scientific experiment buying these and trying them, and it was a waste. These right here are actually pretty good. These are from a company called Skull & Co. And these are ones made for the Switch that I've had for a while. And I've used these on all kinds of things, from my actual Switch to my flight joystick to VR controllers. I really like these, they're really grippy. They have a no-nonsense design without any weird patterns that are uncomfortable. You can kind of tell the rubber on this one is pretty aged and worn. We'll put it on the deck and see how it does. Because they're made for a Switch, it's a better fit because it's a smaller size. But as you can see, this is not good for the gyro. This is great comfort, great grip, but not good for the capacitive sensor. Really quite bad. You're not going to get any use out of that capacitive sensor with these on. But I like these a lot. These are the Skull and Co. for the Nintendo Switch before they started doing their Skull branding. And next up is Skull and Co. when they started doing their Skull branding, which I'm not a fan of, the whole skull thing. I'd prefer to have a simple look to the covers. But these three right here, these two are identical, but these are for Xbox controllers, and they come in a pack with different options. So this one is more of a PlayStation shape, I think, and this is obviously more Xbox. So it's got that diamond knurling on it, and this has more of a bump around the inside and then a dome, whereas this is more concave. I like both of these a lot. These have been my daily drivers for the majority of the time I've had my deck since I found this model of their joystick covers. I have to say that the PlayStation style is grippier. Something about this leathery grain texture is just grippier than the knurling. Knurling can get slippery for some reason. But let's pop these on the deck. They also fit pretty well. A little, not quite as snug as the ones made for Switch, but there's a bit of an air gap. So just resting my thumb, I don't get gyro, but if I push down, I get some, or maybe I don't. Really inconsistent. So I don't use these. Basically, if I would use them for anything except a shooter, I would take them off when I would use these all the time. So I would just take them off whenever I played a shooter. Let's put these on. I'm gonna do a quick pause to make sure my video doesn't break because my phone is crappy. Right, I'm back. Hopefully that last video didn't have any weird errors. Putting on the PlayStation style Skull and Co. one. This one has been my favorite. It has a really good grip. And gyro works actually somewhat reasonably well, as long as you're fully on that thing. But you also need to apply some pressure because there's a bit of an air gap in this one as well. But great grip, great comfort. These are not my favorite only because of this bump around the edge. Excuse me, which is not great for long periods of at least the left thumb. If you're just holding forward, moving, or let's say you're driving or just walking, constantly pushing forward isn't the most comfortable after, I mean, I'm talking like 5 hour sessions. So it does take a while to get uncomfortable, but it does happen. Before I move on to the final two joysticks and, yeah, the last two. I want to go over some non-joystick cover options like this Razer grip tape and this mouse sticker I found on Amazon. These are rubberized sort of tapes that you can cut in a circle and put over the capacitive sensor to make the Steam Deck thumbstick more comfortable while still getting better capacitive ability out of it. So here you can see where I have experimented with some different tapes. This diamond pattern one is the Razer, which feels quite good. So I basically just bought a 12 millimeter hole punch and punched out a hole, which fits perfectly. This is a tape that I don't have on me right now, but it wasn't good anyway, so don't worry about it. And this grainy one right here is from a grippy gun tape, you know, to put on your firearms type of tape that I also got on Amazon, which is really good. It's actually what I've got on my D-pad right now. Really like it because the D-pad is so glossy, it would get slippery. Mainly for like Dark Souls and Elden Ring, trying to flip through things during a boss fight and you're getting sweaty and it's slippery. That's the main reason I put it on there. So you'd be surprised how much just putting a little bit of this helps the comfort of your stick while still allowing you to use the gyro. So put that on there, fits perfectly. This one I just put on there has lost its tape because it's not one that I use all the time. It's one that I've been peeling on and off, but you can see the capacitive still works with the tape, and it does really a lot for how long you can use the stock joysticks before they get uncomfortable. These are really great, but there are better options. So I'm going to take that back off. Okay, now let's talk about the D brand thumb caps that I was so excited for. These, really not that good, in my opinion. The reason I don't like these all that much is that A, it's really not that grippy. It has all these micro dots right here that made me think it would be pretty grippy, but in reality, my thumb just kind of slides over them. Whether that's the material or not, it's definitely not the type of grippy rubber like the Skull & Co. I mean, maybe it's the use of how much I've used them, but you can kind of tell out of the shine. Like, there's a difference in material. One is just grippier, just innately, even before you start adding textures and bumps and lines. And this is more comfortable because this has a sharp edge that it's rubber, right? So it's not like hard, it's not stiff, but you can feel it. There's no reason for there to be that sharp of an angle or a line on your thumbstick, right? Something smooth like this. Even these, which I like, you can tell there's a sharp-ish line that even that I can feel, which is why I give the slight edge to the PlayStation style over the Xbox style, because after a while, not only is this pattern not as grippy as this pattern, but I can feel this line after however so many hours of playing, and this has got to be the worst offender of that. Just a crazy sharp line that you can just feel as your thumb, and your thumb doesn't stick in the middle, it's constantly sliding. Let's put it on, see how it does. Now, Razer told me hey guys, I apologize for all of the cuts, but my phone literally just hates recording and it keeps freezing and I lose clips of audio and it crashes the app. I prefer not to have any cuts in this video, but it just keeps happening. But going back to the D brand sticks, so they advertise that they do not impede the capacitive sensor, and they've even said as much in sort of a Reddit AMA where I asked them directly, hey, some people say their sticks don't impede them, and I've bought them and they do. Some people, when they say it works, it really only means if your thumb's fully on it and not like sort of on the edge. So I'm specifically asking you, does it work like in all scenarios or only when the thumb is on it? And they basically straight up said like our thumbstick cap doesn't impede the sensor at all. But that's just straight up not true because it's pretty unreliable. You have to have your thumb really on that thing, and you have to apply some pressure. See this? Off, and I apply more pressure, and oh, and look at that. It's just stopped working. Before it was you guys saw it working, and now it has stopped working. I don't understand what is so hard about that, but this is, yeah, I can't recommend these for so many reasons. I mean, they're overpriced and they're not that grippy. They're really not comfortable. And the sensor is incredibly inconsistent if it even comes on. And you would have to have your thumb just always in the best case scenario for it to even work, if that. And I can see that it's not working. So we're moving on from these. I really want to tell you guys about my favorite option. I think I've covered all the rest, so we can move on to my absolute favorite. And these are the JSOX thumbsticks. Got these on Amazon. They come with some stickers for the trackpad and the back buttons. And there's a slightly more expensive version which has a tape grip for the side handles of the device. Not a fan of any of those stickers. I have tried a few and they just are too grippy. I like how my finger slides on the base plastic, so that's what I use. These thumbstick caps are really nice. They cover pretty much everything that I want. So they don't have any egregious branding on them. They don't have any crazy sharp lines. I know you can see some ridges around the edge, but you actually can't feel those really. I thought I would when I saw the picture. I was like, oh no, this can be another waste of money where I buy them and I'm gonna feel those lines, but actually no, I don't. They feel pretty good and they just have a nice smooth top that's pretty grippy. These are made out of a silicone, kind of like those flimsy cases, and at first they were really not grippy at all. In fact, I immediately put them away and didn't use them because of just how slick they were. But I really just need to use them for an hour or two and whatever sort of factory sort of, you know, I guess I just had to get some oil on them or something, because now they're pretty grippy. They're sufficiently grippy, and it excels in all the other areas, which I'll say later, that I'll give them a pass for not being the grippiest ones out of the bunch, because they are the most comfortable. They're basically a very similar shape to these, except that they don't have the skull and they don't have the sharp line. So these are really great. This is great for the left thumb when you're just pushing forward all the time, whether you're walking or driving, just pushing forward all the time. They feel great. Before I move on to the sensor, yeah, that's most everything I have to say about the comfort. Now I want to show you the absolute best part. These thumbsticks are actually magic. Let's focus. These joysticks activate the gyro or capacitive sensor anytime you touch them. Just anywhere. You can touch them from underneath. You can come underneath. They activate through my thumbnail. Okay, these things are like conductive. They're crazy. Doesn't matter where you touch them, how hard, low battery, you will activate the sensor. And for that reason, for me, these are the ones to beat. They're also, like I said, just so comfortable. And after using them for like an hour, they gained some grip. They weren't grippy out of the box, but they've gained some grip. And it's just the most consistent. I know when I put my thumb on these, I'm gonna get the sensor activation. But I know a lot of people don't care about that. Even if you don't, I still think these are the ones to beat, because these really give you a long session of comfort and they just feel great. Now, the only downside I will say about these is that these have a pretty ridiculously deep dish. I actually think because of this, even though I just went on about the comfort, it's really actually kind of not that comfortable, just because of how deep that dish is. But the reason it's not a problem for me is because I have all of these hole punched tapes that I've been using. So what I've done, this is some packaging. I've just stacked a couple layers of this tape to basically push up the middle and get rid of that deep groove. So I'm gonna install the right one right now. This is just three separate layers of some different types of this grip tape. Give me a second to put these on and center them. These ones have kind of lost their stick because I keep ripping them on and off. And it doesn't matter because once the thumbstick gets on them, they're not gonna go anywhere. All right, I've installed the three layers of tape underneath, and you can see that the sensor still works from all sides. Didn't do anything to impede it adding all those layers, but now the top is just slightly concave, more on the flat side, which I just prefer. I like that more, having it flat. And now these are just like perfect. These just feel good, and they feel good for hours and hours, and I can use them for gyro, and they are reliable. Whatever material this is, and by the way, not all of these were specially made for Steam Deck. You have to know, you know, most of these didn't fit well. I believe only the D-Brand and the JSOX are specially made for Steam Deck, which means that they fit this profile snug. And I think that is part of the formula for having good gyro activation. I think part of the reason the D-Brand doesn't have good activations, for some reason they put these spacers. It's kind of like they want to distance themselves. My deck's about to die. It kind of seems like they want to distance the joystick cover from the joystick, which I don't see why. It seems to me makes more sense to have a more solid connection to the sensor and not try to, you know, space it with these little pegs. So that's probably why it doesn't work so well. This, here's the inside of the JSOX. So it makes full contact with the sensor, and somehow whatever this material is, it spreads it all the way throughout. And I mean, this has got to be the standard going forward. It's just super good. So that's a look at all the different joystick covers I've had since I got my Steam Deck. I've seen some other ones, but I obviously can't just keep buying, you know, $8-$10 joystick covers, and you know, I don't think neither can other people. So hopefully this video helps you make a decision. I really think you should go with the JSOX even if you don't use the sensor, because they just feel really good. And yeah, nice and grippy. Like, you see how my thumb is staying in position when I'm going left and right. Plus it feels good. Let's put the D-Brand one on the left. There we go. Let's take a look. Yeah, it just doesn't stick, you know? And you can feel that hard edge as you're trying to go around. So, those are my thoughts, those are my opinions. Definitely don't buy any of these. They're just garbage. You know, these are okay. These are definitely the grippiest ones. Like, absolutely, something about this material is so dang grippy. So if you're just a major sweater, playing lots of Elden Ring, stuff like that, and you don't care about the sensor, for sure, you can pick these up. Don't think there's a scenario for anyone to get these, because they're just not that grippy, not that comfortable, and the sensor does not work. JSOX is definitely the best in my opinion. So, thanks for watching, hope it helps, have a good one.